President Tsai has declared that this year's local election, slated for November, will have historic significance. It will be the first time that the assets the KMT has amassed since locating to Taiwan will not be used for electioneering.
The opposition is not permitted to dip into its assets worth 18.9 billion Taiwan dollars, as they have been frozen by a government committee.
2018年的地方选举有一个很特殊的地方.
There is a special aspect to the 2018 local elections. For the first time in post-World War II Taiwan, the KMT's party assets will not be heavily involved in an election. During a conference with NGOs, President Tsai Ing-wen pointed to an investigation of the KMT's party assets. According to a Control UN report outlining the KMT's declared party assets for the year 2017, the KMT has 380 million NT dollars in cash and bank deposits and real estate worth 910 million NT dollars. In addition, it has 1.33 billion NT dollars in restricted assets, as well as assets in trust to the tune of 720 million NT dollars. The KMT's asset holding companies, Xinyu Tai and the Central Investment Corporation, collectively are worth 15.6 billion NT dollars. Overall, the KMT's assets amount to 18.9 billion NT dollars. However, all this wealth has been frozen by the ill-gotten Party Assets Settlement Committee. The KMT needs to make an application with the committee if it ever wants to use it. It should be impossible for the KMT to apply to use its party assets for the purposes of electioneering. It already has party membership fees, political contributions, as well as government subsidies for political parties. If you add on income from all the interest, the KMT has an annual income of approximately over 300 million NT dollars. This is all for the KMT to use freely. However, how the KMT plans to use these funds to boost its chances in the local elections is likely to be a focus of attention in the future.